So another important element of a healthy small group is multiplication. As disciples of Jesus, he instructs us to do what he did, right? To make disciples. And one of the absolute best places to do that is in a small group. Now, that's what we saw Jesus doing throughout the Gospels. He invested in others who would invest in others who would invest in others. Get it? In Matthew 28, Jesus tells his disciples this. He says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I've commanded you." And he said, "Listen, I've shown you how to do it. Now you just go do everything I've shown you to do. Like, just do it." Right? The Apostle Paul does the exact same thing. He tells Timothy, says, "Timothy, the things that you've heard me say in the presence of many witnesses, entrust those things to reliable people who will also be qualified to teach other people." Now, Paul invests in Timothy, who invests in reliable leaders who can do the same thing in others. It's like in Star Wars, right? When Qui-Gon Jinn taught Obi-Wan Kenobi, who taught Anakin. Wait, no, that's a bad example. Anakin becomes Darth Vader, kills a bunch of younglings. Okay, Death Star. All right, try again. It's when Qui-Gon Jinn taught Obi-Wan Kenobi, who then taught Rey, no, who taught Luke, who taught Rey, right? You see generational multiplication. That's what Paul's talking about. Invest in someone who will invest in someone who will invest in someone who will invest in someone. Tracking with me? If you're the small group leader, it's your job to share the load. Invite the members of your group into every part of what you do. Invite others to host. Have other people lead the study. Have other people bring snacks or host a meal. And if you're not the group leader and you're in that small group and you're invited to bring brownies or to organize the group's next serving opportunity or to lead your group's prayer time, that could be your cue to step into what God has designed for you as a Christian and as a disciple. So the bottom line is this: as a small group leader, part of your job is to look for Obi-Wan Kenobi or Luke or Rey. You get it. And if you're Obi-Wan Kenobi and you're asked to lead, say yes. All right, I want you guys to talk about this together as a group. We know that multiplication was important to Jesus. How can your group participate in the process of multiplication? Go.